While our main geometry node series is still going on, let's try and keep up with the new exciting nodes being released every now and then inside Blender. So with the new release of Blender 3.1 comes a list of new nodes. I would say these are more beneficial for procedural system and modeling part. But for now, let's look at these two nodes, extrusion and scale instances. These are one of the most simple to use, which doesn't need any explanation, but I will give you an interesting example anyway, just in case if you are new to geometry node and find it intimidating. So to extrude a geometry, just bring in, so let's start with a default cube and I'm going to click on a new network inside the geometry node editor. From here in the add menu, let's go to the mesh, and over here you can see there are plenty of new things, new nodes. The list is bigger than the last time we saw the geometry nodes. I'll just click on the extrude mesh and plug it right here. So just as expected, all the four faces are being extruded in their own direction. So you have plenty of things to tweak from here, maybe vertices, edges, what you want to extrude. But for now, I'll choose the faces and keep it like this. And the other node I'm going to bring in here is going to be the scale element node, which is also new to the geometry node inside 3.1. So the scale element is going to scale any element inside the geometry. As of now, this entire thing is stitched as one. This is geometry. It's actually going to scale everything. In case if I split all these edges, then the scale element is going to scale all these faces separately. So since all the edges are now broken. So let's get rid of this. Instead of that, we are going to scale elements which are being extruded here. So the top side from the extrude mesh, you have these two outputs, the top side which are these and the side areas which are these, the length area. So the top side, we are going to plug that into the selection of the scale element, and as soon as we do that, you'll see now we are only scaling the top side of the extruded mesh. So to keep this effect subtle, and for today's example that we are going to discuss something like fractals, I'm going to keep it very minimal, like 0.1, and doesn't matter what you put here, we can always change this later. So I have this. Now let's start layering things up and make it more exciting. So I'll press Ctrl G on these two nodes, and that makes it a group. Now press tab to exit the group, and you have this group. Let's call it extrude and insert. So as of now, we don't have any loop node which can actually loop this for the number of iterations. So we are going to do some manual work. All you have to do is just plug this right here again, multiple copies. You can do that with the shift D. Just be careful that the heavier the geometry gets, the slower your computer is going to get. So I think the four iterations work fine. So I'm just going to try my luck and see if the fifth iteration works. So yeah, this works, and now it looks all messed up. But let's go inside the geometry node, the group that we have made. So all of these are copy of the same group. So it doesn't matter which group I select, it's going to show me the same thing. And all of these have the sharing property. So from the scale element, if I scale these now, you'll see something going on which looks like kind of fractal, but it doesn't look really clean. So I'm going to change the offset inside the extrude to 0.01, and that's it. You have something which looks like a pattern repeating on every face. And now if you change the scale, you have the new patterns and the shapes emerging inside this cube's faces. Now I'll go out and press tab and move out of the group and delete one of these. So that's because I'm going to experiment with this a little more. Let's extrude again, and this is going to get heavier. But this time I'm going to bring in one new node, and that would be face area. Let's plug that into the selection. And now I want to extrude only the area which gets bigger than any number, let's say compare. If I bring compare here and type 0.4, so now any face which gets bigger than this number 0.4 gets extruded again. And then scale element and top side. So if I deselect this, if I disconnect this, you have this quite grainy thing going on. We don't want that. We don't want all the faces to have this extrusion. We only want some faces which are maybe larger than 0.4 to break the pattern. That's all. You can actually leave it, you can just make the fractal with these two nodes. That's totally up to you. But for my example, I'm going to just try a bit hard. So you have this extra layer of detail going on for any face which grows bigger than this number. And then let's go out of the group and plug this number here. So now you have this variation, like the bigger shape in the center and the smaller shape on the side. Now if you try to drag and change this number, what will happen is, as soon as this center area grows and becomes bigger than this number, this threshold, the new shapes will emerge in from here, and that will be sent to the new extrude node that we have added here. So just a very basic use of the few nodes which are added here, and there are plenty more things we are going to do with this. So don't worry about that, just take it lightly and just be careful and try not to stack too many of these groups. It could get heavy, and yeah, that's about it. To render, all I'm going to do is go to the shader editor and make sure that I have a cycle render. You can try Eevee if you prefer. Delete this one, bring a glass BSDF, connect this here with the surface, and I'll bring in few lights, maybe a point light, and I'll make a multiple copies of this and try to make a nice layout for myself. And to make the scene a little more exciting, I'm going to add some lights inside these cubes. Just make sure you don't have any HDRI in the background. And then we have these three lights for the different colors. And that's about it. It's going to shine through those transparent glass surfaces and will help bring out those shape of the crystals and the patterns which are forming on the surface. And once you have everything set up, just try and place a camera and animate these values and take some good close-ups. Maybe try a different material for yourself. Just make anything you want. So I hope you guys are enjoying this series. If you are new to Blender's Geometry Node, try out this playlist, which is covering everything you need to know for the beginners, keeping it all simple and clean, and not really getting into too complex examples. So I'm pretty sure you're going to enjoy this series if you're new to Geometry Node. And let's talk about a few more things in the next video about how you can use the materials with the Extrude Node. So I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.